Hello students, today we are going to discuss first chapter question and answers which were left, and most of the students have messaged me to discuss the question and answers of the first chapter. So let's begin the discussion of the first chapter today. So we'll start with the objectives. Till 1879, psychology was a branch of dash. The answer is philosophy B. Second, psychology is a dash science. The answer is B, social science. Next, Dash is considered as a founder of psychoanalysis. Any idea? Right, C, Sigmund Freud. So these are the answers of Phillips, that is B, B and C. Next is Match the Column. So first one, structuralism. It was given by William Wundt E. Second, functionalism, William James D. Third one, behaviorism, John Watson A. And fourth one, cognitivism, C. Ulrich Neisser. So the first one is William Wundt, second is William James, third is John Watson, and the fourth is Ulrich Neisser. Okay, next we move on to the true or false. So first one, psychology is a study of mental processes. So we discussed a lot about psychology, what it is and what the study of psychology is called. So psychology is the study of mental processes. So the answer is true. Second one, case study method is quite often used by a clinical psychologist. So you remember the case of Anna O, that was done by a clinical psychologist, right? So the answer is true. Then the third one, an experimenter is a person on whom the experiment is conducted. What do you think would be the answer over here? An experimenter is a person on whom the experiment is conducted. So the answer is false. It is not an experimenter, it is called as a subject. A subject is a person on whom the experiment is conducted. An experimenter is a person who conducts the experiment. So there's a difference over here. So the answer for true or false is true, true and false. Now we move on to one sentence. The first one, in which year was the first psychological lab established? Do you remember the year? So it was in the year 1879. Next, who is considered as a father of American psychology? Any idea? Father of American psychology? Check in the textbook if you have with you. The father of American psychology is William James, page number 4. So we will go to the page number 4 quickly. It's over here. William James is known as a father of American psychology. It's given on page number 3. Sorry. Next question. What is meant by an experimenter? So it is on page number 4, point number 6. Page number 4, point number 6. So we'll see where it is. Page number 4. So here, page number 4 we reached, point number 6. So this entire thing is the answer. Experimenter, a person who will be conducting this experiment, or the person who conducts an experiment is called as experimenter. So that is the answer for your one sentence. Next question, question number 5. First one talks about replicability. Replicability is on page number 2, point number 5. Replicability. So replication, this entire paragraph you have to write for replicability. I hope you are clear with question number 5. First one, replicability. Okay. Now we'll see question number 5.2. Talks about correlation coefficient. So this entire third paragraph over here, I'm zooming in this paragraph. The extent of correlation between two variables is measured by correlation coefficient. So this entire paragraph will be your answer for correlation coefficient. Clear till here? So question number 5.1 is on page number 2 and question number 5.2 is on page number 7, the third paragraph. Now we move on to question number 6 of your syllabus, chapter 1, that is observation method. Observation method is again on page number 6. Everyone, please go to your page number 6. Page number 6 over your observation method. This both the paragraph you are going to write it down. Then is the next question is about survey method. So survey method, again you are going to write this entire paragraph with the examples. So over here there are some of the examples of survey method. You can see determinants of job satisfaction, the problems of working women, exercise and physical health, cause of the students' absenteeism. So all these examples you can write it down in the answer to make it look more to make it look more informative. So survey method. Then next is a case study method, again on page number 6. So this entire case study method you are going to write. No need to write activity 9. I repeat, no need to write activity 9 over there. This entire case study method you can write it for a short note. Okay. Next question. 6.4 is about the rationality. Okay, importance of rationality. So now in this thing you are going to write this particular definition given by Standish and Scully. Rationality involves an adaptive reasoning, good judgment and good decision making. Once this is done, then you are going to write the 4 points of rationality. That is, over here you can see the 4 points, that is understanding, self-interest, this entire paragraph, self-direction, tolerance, flexibility and self-acceptance. All these points you are going to write it down. So that would be the answer of your 6.4, that is on page number 9. Okay, so this, with this we discuss about the question number 6 over here. Now the last and the most important questions are written down with in detail. So these questions mostly come for the 10 marks. So we'll start with the first one. Write the detailed information of experimental method in psychology. So you need to write in point by point about the experimental method in the psychology. Even the green box you need to write. So this 7.1 is on page number 4. So we'll go on page number 4 again. Okay, so here it is. Page number 4. So this entire thing you are going to write experimental method, what it is, how it is, and then you are also going to write what the problems are, what the hypothesis is, what IV, DV, experimental and participant is. Then you are going to write some of the important points. So till verifiable, you are going to write the answer of experimental method in psychology. I hope you are clear with this. Now we move on to 7.2. 7.2 talks about explain some of the challenges in establishing psychology as a science. Do you remember what were the challenges faced by psychology as science? Do you remember any of those? If you're not remembering them, then you need to again see the video of chapter 1 and get it revised. Okay, so 7.2 is on page number 8. So we'll go back to page number 8 over here. Challenges in establishing psychology as science. So all these 4 points. Psychology as a pre-pragmatic state. Issues of objectivity and reliability, validity, replicability, predictability, and objectifying as humans. So these were the 4 points of establishing psychology as a science. All those 4 points you need to write it down. Fine. Next we move on to the question number 3, 7.3. Explain some of the characteristics of a rational individual. Now this question will be similar to the importance of rationality. All those 4 points you need to write. If you want or if you wish to, then you can also write this particular box over here. Be rational. What are the characteristics? So you can write, you can again start from the definition given by Stonewish. Then you can write the definition given by Sternberg. Then you can write this 5 points of rationality. Then you can write how Albert Ellis has explained rationality. And you can write this entire box. So this particular answer then would look like for a 10 marks answer. Okay, so that is about the characteristics of a rational individual. Next, we move on to explain the types of correlation. Do you remember what the correlation is? A relationship between any two variables. And there were 3 types of correlation. Can you remember them? So there are 3 types of correlation. We will see it quickly. It is on page number 7. Here we are. So you over here, since they have just asked types of correlation, please write the definition of correlation and then start explaining the types of correlation. So in any answer, if you are writing, it is much more necessary that you write the introduction of that questions. If they are asking rationality, so you should need to write definition of rationality in there. Okay, so same way, if they are asking types of correlation, please begin your answer by writing what the correlation actually is, and then you write the types of correlation. So there are 3 types of correlation: positive, negative and zero correlation. So all these 3 you are going to explain to them. Fine. Then you can also make a kind of this diagram for every correlation you are explaining. So for example, if you have written a positive correlation paragraph is done, then you please draw this particular chart over there of positive correlation, then you write a negative correlation, again you draw a particular chart, then a zero correlation and draw a chart. And then you can explain with this certain particular examples you can put in, and you can put that this types of correlation are either positive, negative or zero. So while discussing this chapter, I already discussed activity 12 of which are this correlation standing where, so whether they are positive, negative or zero. So accordingly you have to write. So for example, second one is a zero correlation, weight and intelligence. There is no relation between a weight and intelligence. So while explaining a zero correlation, you can put this example over there. So that would be much more easier for you. Okay, then we move on to the last part of this question answers discussion. Explain the key features of science. So that is on a very beginning of this chapter, that is on page number 2. Explain the key features. So over here we have the key features. There are 6 key features given over here. So again you can start with first one, or again you can start with the definition or where this word science came from, and then you can start explaining all this 6 points. Okay, so I hope you're clear with the discussion of all this. 7th is about is how you are going to self-explanatory answer. So you can solve this question 8 by your own self, and then you can just send me an image of it, and then we can discuss about it. Okay, so it is a self-explanatory answer. Like first one, identify the strongest and the weakest characteristics in you from those explained by Dr. Albert Ellis. So in rationality, he has explained the various characteristics. So what could be the strongest and the weakest for you, that you need to write it down. Then second is, how will you work on your weakest characteristics? Write 2 strategies. So what kind of strategies are you going to use to work on your weakest part? For example, if you have anger issues, then what kind of strategies you can use? So you can Google it over there. You can find out the various strategies to improve your weakest issues. For example, if you're not a social or social person, then you can find it out on Google that how you can be a extrovert or a social, how you can gel more with the people. So that is how you can improve yourself, and then you can write out the answers over here, and then we can discuss much in detail. So with this said, I hope you're clear with the question answer session for the first chapter. All the best. Take care.